travel down dusty Denmark Avenue. At the top of the hill lies a butter-yellow farmhouse, surrounded by three rundown barns, two of which are barely holding on as moss grows over the roofs and the floors, barely able to hold the critters that take refuge inside. The other barn, or rather what is left of it, lays in a pile of old timber and beautifully worn boards, scattered with chip paint of tan and that classic rustic red. Towering over the wreckage stands a silo. The silo remains from the strength of each brick stacked and snuggled on top of the other. This beaten-down farm is my childhood home. Here is where I was marked by the nickname Baby Zoe. This is where my three siblings and I used to spend days on end, running through the overgrown pasture and, at the time, mystery-filled barns. Growing up as the youngest of four kids, I never thought twice of the involuntary title that most people knew me as. Extending even outside of my immediate family, I heard Baby Zoe as the name that would never leave me. I think back to the time when the farm was full of life and curiosities. Whether it was the herd of sheep running away from the dogs, the wind rushing through the fields, or the barn filled with a mosaic of cats. Here I am now, noticing the gradual change that occurred on the farm growing up, too slow to have noticed when I was a kid. Similar to the transformation of the girl with the name Baby Zoe, both have become weaker. They seem to go hand in hand as I slowly recognize Baby Zoe doesn't articulate the person I am becoming. The name has simply faded and the farm has deteriorated as years pass by. Along with these physical and more tangible changes, my perspective has shifted. I don't see Baby Zoe and my childhood home the same. I merely see them as a representation of my younger years, because now I'm surrounded by a landscape that reaches much higher than the collapsing barns, enclosed by sleek and glistening buildings, not to mention stronger. Any building here is destroyed before it becomes too weak, not like the three barns on the farm. There is a certain power here in the city found in both the landscape and myself, especially without the name Baby Zoe. Each step taken away from the farm muffles the voices that speak of my childhood nickname, embraced by the commotion and released from the farm.